2 years and 9 or 10 months since the last conference, and I'm really pleased to see so many of my friends here. And I want to talk a little bit first, though, about tape reliability. And so one of the concerns as we look, or as customers look at tape, is there's this perception of lower reliability than other storage technologies out there. And I'm going to give you a little bit of data. So Spectra, we have millions of tape slots out there in our base, and that with newer drives, with the full height drives, our estimate is that we have a data loss event one per year per 100,000 tapes. So that is sort of the data loss event. If you have 100,000 tapes, could be in a library, could be you know, in a rack, you're going to lose about, you're going to have a data loss event one a year for every 100,000 tapes. And that's actually a pretty small number. And I want to give credit to Mark Hill and Ed Childers, who have worked and worked and worked and worked to get it up to that those levels. And they're not done. They're continuing to move it forward. A lot of reasons it's this good is everything written to tape is simultaneously verified. The recorded time, the length of time data is restorable on tape is about 30 years. But let's go back to that 100,000. Let's say that's not good enough, and that really shouldn't be good enough for most people. This is where if you want a higher or lower error rate, this is where it's essential you do things like erasure coding, or really a simpler one is make two copies. And so, you know, at a larger scale, some of our HPSS clients, they use erasure coding. Certainly in hyperscale, it's common. But for the rest of us mortals, the trivial form, mathematically trivial form of erasure coding is make two copies. Put it on a copy, put it on another copy, could be in the same facility, although you risk the MTBF of the facility, or put it somewhere else. You could have a library in one location, another, as Philippe said, you know, you could write to that other location. But what you really get to have data loss, either a bit error or tape completely shredded. We once had a tape that a customer sent us that was in a parking lot that was run over by a truck. Well, that, you know, that probably was earlier than our where we have the level of success at this point, but that is a total data loss event. But if they're separated, they're handled right, you have to have that kind of event occur on both tapes for you to lose data. So it's just really simple math. Two copies will take you to one out of 100,000 a year times one out of 100,000 a year to like one out of a billion year, one out of a billion tape events a year. So it's just, you know, this is probably what you should do. So that's my view of reliability.